This podcast is powered by the pros at Pascal Air Plumbing and Electric. Arkansas owned, Arkansas operated. GoPascal.com.
What is something cool? We always enjoy our time with Bob Holt. What's up, Bob?
Hey, Matt, how you doing?
Oh, life is good today, man. How are things with you?
Oh, going good. Covered a little baseball this week, and I got a track meet Friday night, big baseball series, and I know softball's doing well, so not quite as crazy with the NFL draft being over in spring football, but certainly baseball. Everybody's excited about baseball, and I think you still have the excitement of hiring John Calipari, too.
Should be intense, Bob, with this baseball series. Is this the first major sport, to happen? I know Justin Moore did a concert there in Lexington not too long after Calipari left. How do you think it's all going to go? Do you think there'll be some boos? Do you think it could be feisty? Do you think they even care as far as the baseball team this weekend?
Oh, well, hopefully they don't. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if they boo Arkansas just because they're the visiting team. They're ranked number two, and they've had a pretty good history against Kentucky, for Arkansas. But, yeah, it will be the first, I think it's right, I think it'll be the first time Arkansas and Kentucky have met in a sporting event since the basketball hiring. Excuse me. So, yeah, there could be. And, yeah, that would be awesome if he threw out the first pitch. I don't think he's going to get that invitation, though. But I know that the story and, our Matt Jones, not the Matt Jones with Kentucky Sports Network, but the Matt Jones at Whole Hog Sports, and not you, put out a video of him, Cal, throwing out the first pitch, and it got a lot of views, and there were a lot of people in there. Some people thought it was the Matt Jones from Kentucky that did it, going, what are you doing going out of Arkansas and posting that video? So there's been a lot of people upset about it or thinking it's fun, and but, yeah, he's brought a lot of attention, whether it's basketball or baseball or whatever the case may be.
And not the Matt Jones, the Australian professional golfer that just went on the LIV Tour last week. So not that one either. So I'm glad we've cleared that up. Bob, when you're looking at this Razorback baseball team and what they've been able to do so far, I mean, just unbelievable. And we're just kind of nitpicking a little bit when something doesn't go right. But what is something that in this series, this three-game series, that you would like to see the Razorback team do a little bit better or something that they haven't been doing at all? What would you like to see this team do better in this series?
Well, man, not to pick on Kendall Diggs. He's a great kid, and he's a really good player, and he's done a lot of big things here, but he's struggling right now. His average is down to 241. He was 0 for 10 last weekend with some strikeouts, left guys on. Dave Van Horn rested him Tuesday night. He played yesterday, had an RBI, had a pretty hard line. It went 0 for 3. So I think, if you're an Arkansas fan, and certainly if you're on the staff or the players, you want to see Kendall Diggs, who's an excellent player who's just in a funk right now. And you hope his shoulder's okay because he's had out some time with that. But he's a guy they really need to get going because he's a key bat. I mean, wasn't that long ago, he was batting 340. Now he's batting 240. So, and Dave batted him clean up. I think they tried to get him going, and he had him hit between Jared Spraglock and Peyton Holt, two guys that have been two of their better hitters of late. And so, I think that in particular, you'd like to see Kendall Diggs, get going with the bat again because he's been a really key run producer for him, had a lot of clutch hits, but is struggling of late. And then Will McIntyre, who's been, a really good reliever for him, he had a great start. His ERA at one point was about 1.75, and now it's like 3.5 or something. But they pitched him an inning against Missouri State Tuesday, and he looked pretty good. But I'd say, for Arkansas to do what people want to do, get to Omaha and have a shot to win the title, they need to get those two guys going again in particular.
Is anybody playing better than Peyton Holt right now? I mean, just over the last month of the season?
Yeah, he's been playing great, and it's been very impressive because that he's done it in a new spot in the outfield. I think he played. Told us the other day he played a little outfield at Crowder Community College before he got to Arkansas. But yeah, he's been super impressive. He's played all. He's an infielder by trade, second baseman, can play third, probably can play short, probably can play first. His teammates say he could play all nine positions. So I think the games have probably passed where he go out there and pitch or something. In a midweek game against somebody they're going to dominate. But Yeah, he's been very impressive. I mean, number one, he's given him a huge boost offensively because he does a good job of getting on base, had a home run yesterday, good run producer. And then, you know, he's played really good defense in the outfield. And everybody, I think most anybody that watches sports saw the, I guess called the deke play he did against the Gators last Saturday in the first game of the doubleheader, where he faked the catch and then confused the runner. And, you know, the tied run ended up not – Arkansas ended up maintaining the lead because Peyton Holt basically faked this guy out and he got thrown out at home. And so – and he – I think he went to the outfield maybe a month ago in terms of working on it in practice. And then Dave said that – Dave Van Horn, the coach, said that they needed, you know, boost offensively from the outfield. And Peyton Holt has done more – you know, he's supplied that and more. And his defense has been really good. He's made some good running catches, takes good routes to the ball, just a good, heady player all the way around. And you know, that was, I think, the Sports Center number one play. Somebody kind of compared it to, well, I can't remember if it was 2018 or 2019, but one of those Chad Morris years where the North Texas punt returner faked out Arkansas with a fair catch and then scored a touchdown. This is sort of a baseball version of that. But, yeah, Peyton Holt's helping him in a lot of ways.
That was this Matt Jones, Bob. That was yeah, that's the first thing. That's exactly what it reminded me of. I do want to ask about Hagan Smith. Is he the Golden Spikes winner this year? Is there anything this dude can't do? I mean, just what a remarkable season. Can you put it in words how good he's been this year?
Well, he's just been money for him on the mound every Friday night. And I think Arkansas is 11-0. When he starts, he's 8-0. He had a no decision, I believe, against Florida. But yeah, he's been great. I mean, he's been very durable. He pitches deep into games. He doesn't walk hardly anybody. That's one reason he pitched deep into games. He usually is going to give you seven. He gave him six innings. He gave him seven last week. And you've seen several of these SEC teams have not pitched their number one guy against them. I would say that's the ultimate compliment because, and they may use different, you know, reasons, but I think the main reason is they don't want to, they feel like, well, gosh, if Wilbert, you know, our number one star will go out there and throw a good game, but Hagan Smith will throw a better one and we'll lose. And then, you know, so we'll save our number one guy and hope, you know, they have a better chance winning game two or three against Arkansas. So, he's just been, he's throwing triple digits sometimes, you know, high 90s. You know, everybody you talk about says he's going to be probably the first college pitcher off the board. Golden Spikes, you know, Charlie, I'm trying to get the guy's name at Georgia. He's probably going to win that. He's got like 30-something home runs.
Oh, my goodness.
And then you also got Jack, Klondine, who Arkansas faced last week, who's a lead hitter, and he also pitches. So all due respect to Hagan, I think it'd be probably one of those two guys that would probably win it. And there may be some guys outside the SEC I'm not aware of, but I think Hagan's the top college pitcher in the college ranks right now for sure.
Hey, Bob, this basketball portal, football portal, it's all new. It's all wild, wild west. And looking at the six guys that Arkansas has so far, that last one from Tennessee, is it Adu, if I'm saying his name right? What do you remember about him? I remember him being, you know, tall, athletic, being able to defend. Is he you got him penciled in as our starting center for next year?
I would think so. What I remember about the Tennessee-Arkansas game, I think Tennessee won that game. I don't have the box in front of me, but I think they won 92-69. Mm-hmm. At that point, Arkansas was playing better, and I didn't think they'd beat Tennessee, but I didn't think Tennessee would come in here and basically dominate them in the second half. And he just killed them. I think he hit 11 of 14 shots.
Double-double, you know, yeah.
And they weren't all dunks. He wasn't, you know, jacking up threes either, but I thought he had a nice shooting touch. He's very aggressive, rebounded, blocked shots. He's basically exactly what you need, and I'm sure any team would love to have him. I don't know why he left Tennessee, if that was an NIL deal or he just wanted to play for Cal or what happened there, but or maybe he just loved Walton Arena. But old Tennessee's got a pretty good fan base, too, and a nice big arena. But, that was a huge pickup. And I don't know how Cal's going to manage his minutes, but certainly he's going to get starters minutes. I'll put it that way. I would expect him to be in the lineup. And, yeah, I think they're just a big, big pickup. But I think about that kid, he's shown, you know, good improvement every year. His stats have made a good quantum leap from freshman to sophomore to junior. Now he'll be a senior. And so he's a guy that's shown steady improvement. I remember after the game, Eric Musselman talked about how impressed he was, how improved he was. And so that's the kind of player you want for sure.
Yeah, I'm thinking you're looking at this team come together. I guess we need a little bit of everything. Do we have a point guard yet, Bob, that somebody that we know that, man, that's going to be our guy?
Well, I think that the Davis kid they just got from Florida Atlantic, mm-hmm. who, if you remember, Florida Atlantic went to a Final Four a couple of years ago, had a good run this year, made the tournament again, and they got their coach Dusty May the Michigan job. But, yeah, I think he'll probably be a primary ball handler for them, and that's, frankly, something they struggled with last year. We've talked about that. They had guys that, you know, you thought, okay, he's the guy, but then it didn't turn out that way. And so, yeah, I think Davis, he's an experienced guy. He's played at a high level. He's played in a Final Four. And so, I think he is maybe the number one guard out there in the portal, certainly in the top five. And so, yeah, those two guys you just mentioned, those are huge pickups along with all those hot shot freshmen they're getting too.
Hey, have you been keeping up at all with the NBA playoffs?
Oh, yeah. That's the time of the year I do. If I watch the NBA, didn't get to watch yesterday because I was at baseball, but I definitely enjoy
watching.
Did you
see that Knicks Sixers game?
I didn't get to watch it. I read about it, watched some highlights, and yeah, I probably like a lot of people, I expect the Knicks to close them out at home, and you got to give the Sixers credit for, you know, coming back and winning that game in overtime, and now, you know, New York's still leading 3-2, but now it goes back to Philadelphia. And so if the Sixers tie that, you know, if they win, I guess it's tonight, and it goes 3-3 back to New York, I mean, all the pressure is going to be on the Knicks because it's like, are you going to blow a 3-1 lead?
Oh, my goodness, right.
New York's a pretty tough fan base. They love their Knicks. But so, yeah, that's been a real good series. And, of course, you know, Bobby Portis had a big game the other night to help Milwaukee force a game 6 against the Pacers. And, you know, we know Milwaukee's playing shorthanded with some injured stars out, and Bobby Portis, he's been a key guy for the Bucks anyway, but he's really important now.
BetOnline is your number one source for all your betting needs. Get the latest odds, lines, and matchup reports for baseball, boxing, golf, and more. BetOnline continues to be the fastest and easiest way to place your wagers, including live betting and your favorite casino and card games available to play right from your phone. Head to the website or use your mobile device to sign up today and get in on the action. Remember to use our promo code BELIEVE, that's BLEAV, for your 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. Bet online, where the game starts.